Morning all of you, welcome back to course of computing. Our today's topic of video is introduction to Hopf Field Network. So in the last video we tried to understand the concept of Hebbian learning. So we understand how the learning, the process of learning which takes place in the human being, how that same learning will happen in the artificial neural network. So for that purpose, how Hebbian learning help us. So this we understand in the last video. Now today we are going to discuss about one more type of a ANN, that is a Hopf Field Network. So let's try to understand about Hopf Field Network. So Hopf Field Network is also one of the kind of recurrent ANN. Okay, it's one of the kind of recurrent ANN in which all the neurons are connected with each other, are fully interconnected with each other. This is what important things. Again, I'm saying, I'm just again explaining what is a Hopf Field network. Hopf Field network is a such a type of recurrent neural network in which all the neurons are fully interconnected with each other and no neuron has connection to itself. So let me tell you, let me visualize this thing. So here we can see that each neuron is connected with each other. That means it's a fully interconnected network. So this is how the structure of Hopf Field network is. If you try to correlate with, if you learn about the types of topology in case of a networking, then you come to know that there are various types of topology, bus topology, ring topology. So there is one topology, that is a mesh topology. In case of a mesh topology, all the computers are connected with each other. Every computer in the network is connected with every other computer in the same network. In the same way, Hopf Field network is there. In case of Hopf Field network, we can say that it's a type of ANN in which all the neurons are connected with each other. All the neurons. So here you can see X1 is connected to X2 also, 5 also, 4 also, 3 also. Similarly, 2 is connected with 1, 5, 4, 3. That means every neuron in the this network is connected to every other neuron in the network. So this network was developed by John Hapfield in the year of 1982. And this Hopf Field network consists of only single layer. This is a single layer network in which in single layer n number of neurons are there, and these neurons are connected with each other. And the speciality is that no neuron has connection to itself. Means that one neuron is connected with other. It is providing output, whatever the output produced by one neuron given as an input to another one, but it is not taking to itself. Means it this is the speciality of Hopf Field network, that every neurons are connected with all other neurons, but it is not have any connection to itself. This is what the main feature of Hopf Field network. And in this case, in case of Hopf Field network, we can say that it's a symmetrically weighted network. Now the thing is that what do you mean by symmetrically weighted network? So its meaning is very simple. So in this case, between x1 and x2 there is a value of weight x12. So this x12 represents the weight from x1 to x2. Now the value of weight should be same if you move from x3 to x1. That means the value of x12 is similar to the value of x21. Both are the same. This is not the case, that only representation is different. Means this w12 represents the value of weight from neuron x1 to x2. It is same as that of weight w21, because it represents the value of a weight from neuron 2 to 1. So that's why we are saying that it's a symmetrically weighted network. That means the value of weight should be same if you are moving in forward direction or in the backward direction between the two neurons which are connected with each other. Then every unit also act as an input and output of the network. This is again another important feature that you understand about the Hopf Field network. If you try to visualize this kind of structure, then you understand that Hopf Field, what is the Hopf Field network. So just try to remember or try to recall the concept of mesh topology. Similar to that, there is a Hopf field network. And where to use this Hopf field network? Now we understand what is a Hopf field network, what is the specialty or features of Hopf field network. Now the next thing is that where we should apply Hopf field network. So Hopf field network can be used for auto association and optimization problem, like a traveling salesman problem. In case of a traveling salesman problem, we need to find the optimum path that a particular salesman has to adopt in order to visit all the city only once. So Hopf field network can be used in various optimization problem like traveling salesman problem. So this is what the just structure of a Hopf field network. And at the last, I am going to tell you what are the different types of Hopf field network. So there are basically two types of a Hopf field network. One is a discrete Hopf field network and second one is a continuous Hopf field network. Now let's try to understand what is a discrete Hopf field network, what are its feature. So it's a type of network in which it operates in a discrete line fashion. Discrete line fashion means what? In this case, input and output pattern are discrete vector. That means in this case, the value of variable can be either in the binary, that means either 0 or 1, or it is a bipolar. Bipolar means either minus 1 or plus 1 in nature. So this is what a specialty of discrete Hopf field network. In case of a discrete Hopf field network, the output variable is represented with a binary either 0 or 1, or it is a bipolar, that is plus 1 or minus 1. And this network has a symmetrical weight. Just we understand what is the concept of symmetrical weight. So discrete Hopf field network has a symmetrical weight with no self connection. This is again the same thing that we because discrete Hopf field network is one of the type of Hopf field network, so it borrow the same feature from original Hopf field network. That is, in this case the network has a symmetrical weight and it has no self connections. That means the value of wij is same as that of wji. So in this case we can say that one neuron is I, second neuron is j, and wij represents the value of a weight from neuron I to j, which is similar to value of a weight from neuron j to I. And in this case wii equals to 0 as well as wjj equals to 0. Why is it so? Because it has no self connection. That's why the value of weight to another neuron is there, but value of a weight to itself is not there. Its value is 0. That's why in this case the value of wii is 0, as well as the value of wjj is also 0, which I have not mentioned over here, but from this we can conclude. So this is how the discrete Hopf field network is. So exactly opposite to that discrete Hopf field network, we have continuous Hopf field network. So in this case of a continuous Hopf field network, the output variable is continuous in nature. Continuous in nature means what? In case of discrete Hopf field network, the value of output variable is either 0 or 1 or minus 1 or plus 1. But in case of continuous Hopf field network, we have the value which lies between 0 and 1. This is what a important thing that you note about the continuous Hopf field network. In case of a continuous Hopf field network, the value of output variable lies between 0 and 1. But in case of discrete Hopf field network, it is either 0 or 1, or it is plus 1 or minus 1. But it is continuous in nature. The value can be 0.1, 0.2, 0.253, and so on. So this is continuous Hopf field network. So I hope you understand what is Hopf field network, where you use Hopf field network, and what is the architecture. This is what architecture we have seen about Hopf field network, and finally we discuss about the types of Hopf field network. So there are two types. One is a discrete Hopf field network and continuous Hopf field network. Thank you.